All right, Grand Rising, everyone, it's Yolanda, and welcome back. So, yeah. So I can't remember where the camera cut off, right? Or the video cut off, but I find it really strange because it's almost like there's this a trade of some sort coming on. Now, let me tell you about when manifestation with words was really strong with me about a year and a half ago. Because I remember it's some lyrics in like Kanye's song that says something like, I don't know if it's law of attraction. I mean, something attraction. But is that be careful what you ask for? I got exactly what I asked for. I mean, I just think that was a very fucking magical time, whenever that was. But I remember we were going through it here and everything has been open. Like, I didn't hide anything about anything from anybody, you know? But I remember having a conversation saying, hold on. Ooh, wait, look, I done spilled the tea all on my knee. Hold on. So I remember having a conversation with the soulmate, the Taurus. And see, I think it's hard with him because I'm a fucking Taurus too. I think at least. I mean, and this one, we were not separated yet, okay? And he said, well, yeah, you know what? If, and I remember him saying if, because I was trying to explain what I felt was going on here. And he said, yeah, if a Drake or a Kanye West came over here to get you or something like that, they can have you. And then I know you ain't crazy, right? And then, what did he say? Then I'll know you're not crazy. I'll say, yeah, God did this and everything like that. Because he don't really believe, right? His family don't know that, but he don't. So, or didn't. Well, I don't know. So, anyway. And I said something like joking around, like, yeah, as long as they leave you a bad bitch or something like that. It'll be like a trade or something, or a fair trade or some shit like that. And he was like, yeah, then I'll be down for it or whatever. You know, but we were just like, I don't know. I thought we were like, you know, it was just like one of them conversations, like, yeah, yeah, that's probably what you're thinking. Or maybe like, you know, it was just like that. But the whole energy, like I said, is something. It's like something was. Now, it seems like within this past week, a shift has happened. It felt like something was standing on the other side. Like something was trying to lure me out. But many times I've gone and, because I do like these little one night or two night, you know, I like hotels, right? I like this. Yeah, I like them. I don't know why. And I like to be alone in them. And I like to just, you know, vibe, you know. And then sometimes I think just with the history, I like older buildings and architecture and stuff like that. So sometimes with the design, I feel like I sense different things than when I'm at home. That's what I feel like it has something to do with some towers or something here in between where this house is. And it was strategic that I came to this house. It took us 4 years to find a house. We had given up and finally this house came. And it's just, it's strange. Because it's prophesied in that book. The people trying to take Esther into a mental facility in the book. The fact of her father not wanting her to scry or use her gifts, but Elijah was saying that they were going to change the world with it. But I don't know who Elijah is. That's the whole thing. I don't know. You see what I'm saying? I don't know who Elijah is today. I don't know if it's the I don't know which one of them it is, but it brought me back to like how all this seemed like a dream or something fake, because if you really think about it, like things have slowed down. The entertainment industry slowed down. Things like this slowed down. But I did notice that when I think about goat energy and the two goats in Inanna, and when I think about this energy here, and Astaroth, okay, and the two kings or the two, it made me think like the coming in the clouds part or whatever, like iCloud or whatever, I don't know. So it just made me think, like I said, for the past 2 years within, you know, well, I guess within America, not even like just the indigenous community, with the two main, in the media, there was main focus. And I don't, you know, I congratulate or whatever, but because if that's, you know, what somebody's working towards or whatever, that's what I congratulate or whatever, but I don't tend to emphasize, I don't like talking about other people's money. You know what I'm saying? I never have. I think it's tacky. I don't like it. But, you know, I remember that the mass media and like social media was going crazy about talking about how much money this person had and how much money and how many records or how much money this person had. And if you think about it, those are the only two goats when it comes to music that have been propped up in the past 2 years and a lot of emphasis put on them. And then again, the emphasis on the division between them, the war in the heavens, and then the whole thing about them coming back together to free Larry Hoover, right? And then it just makes me think that in my, like I said, when it comes to my dome, right? At that point in time, those were the two energies, right? But I know things have changed. Whatever was supposed to happen, maybe was supposed to happen. It was supposed to happen a different way then, but it was more a collective or something, I feel, to get me to see. It was like to wake me up or whatever. Which makes me think about something, about some story about somebody sent to wake up an Arabic princess or something like that. And then I think it was a lot of stuff about Netanyahu, okay? And we talked about that in the biblical text. Excuse me. And so, yeah, that's what I'm saying. So I don't know. But I know that there was something in there about dying for this person. You know, dying, like in that book, like it was like that Bonnie and Clyde, Romeo and Juliet kind of energy when it came to the book, The Spring, with the prophecy in it. So maybe that's the whole thing about bludgeoning. But it gives me the energy of like, okay, so if those papers are missing, now I never signed the papers, but if they're missing, I feel like now just the shift in my energy, it's like a walking, like the Fool card in the alternative deck, walking off the cliff. But the person ended up drowning, right? So it's like now that I want to walk off, it seemed like there's some animosity or something, but a last ditch effort where somebody's trying to lead me or lure me or show me. But at the same time, I feel like everybody has moved on with their lives. And now I'm just this thing. Even the person, you know, here that might, it just make me think like, what's going on? Is it, did somebody else have access, gain access to the home and get the papers? You know, like, is there a common law energy here? Or did the person that's here really take the papers in because they have plans? And is it because of some type of policy or something is taken out on me? And you know what I'm saying? Like somebody just waiting for me to be driving down the road and a wheel pop off the fucking car or something. You know, like just crazy shit that I never thought I would have to worry about. But I feel like whatever the thing is, these people have moved on, or because I won't agree to like any kind of third party or shared polyamorous energy. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I know when it comes to like kings and kingdoms and stuff, and we think about it in that way or whatever, that they have mistress, they have whatever, but you know what I'm saying? They do things or whatever. They just do. But I'm just saying, like, again, you can't have two queens, right? I know that there's shit that goes on when it comes to kingdoms. And I think that's what the whole King Solomon energy was about. All them wives was about like a kingdom or whatever being built or something. It was about growth in land and finances. But it's like Sheba was queen. And at one point in time, it felt like that, but now it feels like, you know, somebody's trying to like front me off like a fucking pauper or something. You know what I'm saying? And so it's like that. It's like, even if there is something else going on that I can't see, why can't I see? You know what I'm saying? And then it's just whole energy. If I do go off or just, you know, find a way to get out. And go towards somebody. Did they already marry me? I don't know. Like this shit, because they were talking about hypnosis. She was being hypnotized by people, and doctors and stuff were all around her. But I'm trying to think if this was like in a spirit realm or something. Like, I'm trying to figure out how much of this was, you know, her abilities, and how much of it was like real. So again, that's the thing. If somebody already moved along, but they also, you know, have this, it just made me wonder, like, then why am I not aware of these things? Why, it's like I'm this floating energy that people are like, whatever. And it's just like, I don't know, it's weird to me. Cause almost like this elimination thing or something. It should be something feeling nice. You know, nicely done, like everybody knows, everybody came to agreement, and this is it. But it feels like everybody else has come to agreement. I don't have a choice. And it's almost like maybe in order to get this inheritance, you have to be married. But that don't even make no sense. It just seemed like somebody knew I was going to get this inheritance, and some motherfuckers split up some shit, and then they narrated it this way. And it's like, if it is right now with me speaking, it's like, if the person already is married and they already have the funds, then I don't have a, you know what I'm saying? I don't have a say so, because, you know, if you married with someone, if it was me, I would not be married to nobody. I would be smart enough not to marry nobody right away. You know, and it's bringing me back to the Britney Spears thing. I promise you it is. Because she was going to go off and marry her fiance or whatever. Then we never heard about that storyline again. We never seen Britney Spears again. They showed the pictures of her provocative in the shower or something. And I've been thinking somebody's been planted a camera or something in my shower. You know, so it's almost like blackmail, but it's almost like somebody is doing, it's just some twisted shit going on here. Sometimes I feel like it's almost like Handmaid's Tale 3D, 5D or some shit. You know, where these documents are being signed, sealed, and delivered behind the scenes in the 3D, but, you know, like I said, the relationship is in another dimension that I don't have access to. But I have the mindset to figure it out. But again, it is like, it's something that's maybe new worldly, is to me anyways. Like, maybe the whole world already knows that this shit is going on, and I'm the last one to find out. But like I said, because I'm pretty much keep to myself or whatever, but it's just a strange situation I think to be in, because all the energy is saying, oh yeah, you know, you're gonna be going off into a new life, everything's about to be fine and everything. But it's like, how does it seem like, even when it comes to the tarot community, or when it comes to me expanding my senses to like the ninth fucking something, to the ninth power or something, right? I'm pretty sure there's something, I don't know. This is just me getting this information on my own with the help of the ancestors, guys, and source, okay? Whatever, the ether or something, shit, I don't know. So what's stopping it from, you know, whoever this is that may, you know, be on the other side preparing something? It could be all good, and somebody might just be waiting for me to, but then again, it just seemed like a letter should have came to the house, somebody should have knocked on the door, I should have got an email, you know, it just seemed like some shit like that. Or else it's like everybody's trying to keep the shit quiet, because the end game is to get the money and get rid of the girl. You know what I'm saying? And I had to just be honest about me feeling that way. Like, anybody's going to feel that same way in this position here. You know? And it kind of does feel like a defect or something. Yeah, it does feel like a defect because maybe even, that's why I don't want to like dash out like blame or anything, because it could be that people just think that everybody has this sense of awareness right now, that I should have this sense of awareness. So whoever's on the other side might not know the way that I'm interpreting this and seeing this. They may not know that I'm not clearly fully aware. Like I said, and I feel like it has something to do with placement here and signals being crossed or mixed, or maybe like intel, some kind of fifth generation intel or something, in a way to block that. So, I don't know. I don't know. And then again, the wars and rumors of war about the Ukraine, and Russia's definitely about to move in any moment. You know, it's just make it like it's a symbolizing something else here. It's like it's symbolizing something else altogether. Because again, when you read between the headlines, there's always a dual nature to it. Always has been, but I feel like it's more direct now with this current situation here. It's almost like a woman can't make her own decision by herself, or, you know, whatever. It's like all these kings have gotten together and they're like, okay, we'll pass her off, but we just got to make sure that she has a, you know, somebody else, you know. And it's just like, what? You know, I feel like, again, a woman should be able to choose. If this is the kind of, you know, conditioning or the kind of whatever we're going through at this point in time. And I think it's kind of sickening to see so many people that I feel like aren't having visions or know about it, but they can only give what they can give, to be honest. You know, so again, I'm always appreciative for any soul sibling or something that drops something that makes me think. It's almost like casting out seeds. It's kind of like what I do. So how can I, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like, you know, it's a dire situation at this point in time. So if I knew something about something, like, I would have to be the hero. Like, I would have to be the hero and just bust out and go to this person and tell them something. And it feels like I don't have that. It's not that kind of support. It's almost like I told y'all with that Black Mirror episode where everybody's just looking on. And maybe even enjoying it a little bit. You know? Maybe even enjoying it. So I don't know. Just documenting, or just in case. I have a couple numbers to some attorneys. I already called, who did I call? I already called Gruber. Somebody was supposed to get back to me, but I don't think that they did. But maybe I'm going to call them back. Because she said they couldn't help me with that, but she could help me with one thing that I asked about. So I'm going to call back there. And then I won't say the name of the other two places, because she said that these are the places that will actually probably be able to help me when it comes to inheritance and wills and stuff like that. So I don't know. I'm just drinking my tea right now. And I guess that's just what I'm about to do. It just so happens that it's funny. Like I said, when it comes to the energy with the daughter, every time when I feel like I'm going to have to flee or go, you know, like, you know, or even, you know, the side job that I have to take on in order to, you know, be prepared or whatever, to save up for something. It's like, you know, yeah, there's always some kind of pause or break here where I have something now. I have a job I have to do for the next couple of days or whatever. And it feels like these are the couple of days that I needed to be free. But like I told you, it's always, like I said, whenever there's something where I'm almost like to a point where it's like an escape bay or something, you know, not like I'm running off like that. Like, I would just do what I'm going to do and maybe call from a distance, you know, so there's no problems. Yeah, it's when somebody needs me to do something and I said no, but I ended up saying yeah, and because I needed it. I needed to have the job. And so,
I don't know. Hopefully everything will be all right. But like I said, it's just perfect time. It seemed like it'd be perfect timing, you know. Seemed like it'd be perfect freaking timing. But then I had to worry about this energy. Like, because whatever this is, it feels like this energy is connected to one of these masculines. My daughter. Somehow. And, you know, this could be a situation where, you know what I'm saying? Did somebody get all that shit together? You know what I'm saying? So they can run off with, you know, somebody. Could it be, you know, some weird shit like that? I don't know. I don't know. And that's why I feel like the whole push me to the edge energy right now.